Okay, welcome to a video on applications of the law of cosines. Let's go ahead and review the law of cosines first. Remember, there are three forms to the law of cosines. The important part to remember is whatever angle we're using here on the right side, we must use the opposite side on the other side of the equal sign. An engineering firm decides to bid on a proposed tunnel through a mountain. To find the tunnel length, the measurements shown are taken. Part A, how long is a tunnel? Part B, the cost is $4,500 per foot. If the company wants a 20% profit, what is the bid amount? Okay, let's go ahead and start by finding this length here. Let's go ahead and call this side A. So this would be angle A. This will be side B. And this will be side C. So using the law of cosines, A squared must equal B squared plus C squared minus 2 times B times C times cosine A. Now we need to solve for A. You may want to check these on your calculator, but now we're going to add and subtract on the right side. So we have A squared equals $579,532.05. Now we can take the square root of both sides. So we have A is approximately 761 yards. So this is part A, how long is the tunnel? For part B, the cost is $4,500 per foot, and they want to know what is the bid amount if they want a 20% profit. Let's take this information over to the next screen. So first we have 761 yards of tunnel to dig, but the cost is in feet. So let's go ahead and convert this to feet. 1 yard is equal to 3 feet. So the units of yards simplify out, and we're left with 761 times 3 will give us the total number of feet. That's 2,283 feet. And the cost is $4,500 per foot. So the cost to drill that tunnel is going to be $10,273,500, but that's just the cost. If they want a profit of 20%, well, 100% plus 20%, we want 120% of this amount, or the cost. So we'll multiply this by 1.2, and that'll give us the bid amount. So it looks like we'll have $12,328,200. Remember, to find the percent of a number, you just convert to a decimal and multiply. Okay, we have time for one more application problem. There's a transmission tower near I-10. The range of the service from the tower forms a 47 degree angle and a range of 28 miles to one section of I-10 and 31 miles to another point on I-10. If a driver is traveling at 50 miles per hour, how long will she have service? So the difficult part about this one is going to be the setup. So let's go ahead and label this as our road. So here's I-10. There's a transmission tower, let's say, to the west, and it forms a 47 degree angle. So the transmission goes out from the tower like this, forming a 47 degree angle. And the range is 28 miles to one section of I-10 and 31 miles to the other. So let's just label this 28 miles and this 31 miles. This would be the distance where the driver would have service. So let's go ahead and label this D. We first need to find this length and then determine how long it will take that driver to go that distance driving 50 miles per hour. So again, we can find the value of D using the law of cosines. Remember, if we have the side D or D squared on the left side of the equation, we'll have cosine 47 degrees on the right. So we'll have D squared equals 28 squared plus 31 squared minus 2 times 28 times 31 times cosine 47 degrees. Remember, if we use this angle, then the side opposite that angle will be on the left side of our equation by itself. Let's go ahead and start simplifying the right side. So d squared is equal to 561.0508. Now we'll take the square root of both sides to find the value of d. Remember, d would have to be positive, so d is going to be approximately equal to 24 miles. So the distance here is approximately 24 miles. So there's a 24-mile distance where the driver will have service. Now, since the driver is traveling 50 miles per hour, the question really becomes, how long will it take the driver to travel 24 miles? Because that's how long the driver will have service from this transmission tower. So since distance equals rate times time, time would equal the distance divided by the rate. The distance is 24 miles, and the rate is 50 miles per hour. This quotient will give us the time in hours, which is 0.48 hours. Let's go to the next screen and determine how many minutes this would be. 0.48 hours. Well, there's 60 minutes in 1 hour. The units of hours simplify out, so 0.48 times 60. So the driver would have service for approximately 29 minutes. Now the reason I'm always rounding to, and notice how I'm rounding to two significant digits, and the reason I am is because notice that all of the given information has two significant digits, so I'm maintaining that consistency throughout this problem. Sometimes textbooks ask you to round to a specific place value. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you and have a good day.